So hello all, in this video we will see different variants of Turing machines. The main variants of Turing machine are universal Turing machines, then multi-tape Turing machines, then non-deterministic Turing machines and enumerator Turing machine. So these are the different variants of Turing machine, and having these two, this four, universal Turing machine and multi-tape Turing machine. I mean, we have already discussed them in our previous videos. I will put the links to those videos in the description box. So these two variants were already been discussed. So in this video we will be discussing non-deterministic Turing machine and enumerator Turing machine. Also, while discussing multi-tape Turing machine, I forgot to tell you how a single-tape Turing machine can simulate a multi-tape Turing machine. That is, even if a Turing machine has multiple tapes, a single-tape Turing machine can do the very same job. I meant that having multiple tapes does not add anything to the computational capability of a Turing machine. That is, whatever a multi-tape Turing machine can do can also be done by a single-tape Turing machine. Okay. For example, if a Turing machine is having k tapes, here let's take k as 2, we can create a single-tape Turing machine with 2k tracks. Okay, so this is a single tape with 2k tracks. So in the first track, for example, if the contents are like blank A, blank here and here, this for tape 1 for multi-tape Turing machine, this is single tape Turing machine. So if it is having these contents and the different tapes, we can have a single tape Turing machine with 2 into k tapes. For example, if it is having two tapes, here we can have 4 tapes. So the first, second tape and fourth tape will be containing these contents. For example, B, A, blank, etc. The fourth tape also will be containing the contents. So B, 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 like this. So you'll be thinking, what about the other two tapes? So these two tapes will store the information regarding the tape heads. For example, the positions of tape heads will be recorded in these two tapes, these two tracks. For example, if the tape head is pointing to blank here and A here and blank here, so that will be indicated here. This is the first tape head, this is the second tape head, this is the first tape content, this is the second tape content. We have a single tape, but the tape is having 4 tracks here, 2 into K tracks here for a K tape multi-tape Turing machine. So we can always simulate this. Now the transitions of this Turing machine and informations regarding different states will be encoded in the finite control of this Turing machine. So it has the tape contents, it has the tape head positions, so that it can scan the symbol present in different tape heads, and it has information regarding transition and its finite control. So it can do anything this Turing machine can do. So this way we can always simulate a single tape Turing machine. A single tape Turing machine can always simulate a multi tape Turing machine. Okay, so that is one thing I forgot to discuss in the previous video. So non-deterministic Turing machine, as you can guess, is just like non-deterministic automatons. That is, for a particular state and the input, it will be having lots of different transitions possible. For example, P1, some symbol Y and some direction D1, then P2, some state P2, some symbol Y2, some direction D2, then some other symbol P3, some symbol Y3 and some direction D1, like this. So lots of choices will be possible. So if we can take a sequence of choices such that if we end up at the final state, the string is accepted. Otherwise, now such sequences of states can lead you to the final state. That means the input is rejected. That's it. Just like non-deterministic automaton. Again, non-deterministic Turing machine and deterministic Turing machines are having same processing power, same processing capability. That means anything that is accepted by a non-deterministic Turing machine can be accepted by a deterministic Turing machine also. That is, non-determinism doesn't add anything to the processing power of a Turing machine. So they are equivalent. Now the last kind of Turing machine is enumerator machines. So enumerator machines can enumerate a particular language. It will be generating all the strings one by one, which are getting larger progressively. For example, of the languages A raised to N, B raised to N, where N is greater than or equal to 0, you know that the first string is epsilon, the second string is A, B, the third string is A square, B square, fourth string is A cube, B cube. So all such strings will be generated one after the other by an enumerated machine. So how does it happen is, enumerator machines will be usually having two tapes. So what happens is, in the first tape, the first step will be having the final output. In the first step will be putting hash hash to indicate epsilon. That means the empty string can be generated by it. Between two hashes lies the input. Now the next thing, so this is step one. Now the next thing that you need to do is, from the step onwards, you have to repeat it to generate all the strings. So what you have to do is, you have to write an A in the second tape. So you have to copy this A to this particular tape and copy this many B's also to this tape. So you will get AB. Now you can put a hash to indicate that this string is over. Now what you have to do is, you have to add one more A to tape 2. Now repeat the same thing. That is, you have to copy this to tape 1. Now write as many A's as many B's as that of A's as you have copied. So you can write 2 B's. Now put a hash to mean that the string has been, this particular string is over. Now add one more A. Now copy these many A's into this particular tape and write these many B's also, and put a hash to indicate the end, and this goes on so that you can generate all the strings of this particular language, which are getting progressively larger one after the other. So this is how enumerated Turing machines work. So these are the four different variants of Turing machine. Hope you understood. Thank you.